हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम प्रोफेसर पंकज शर्मा। हेयर इज माय अनदर वीडियो, इंडक्शन मोटर डिज़ाइन पार्ट टू। आई एम फ्रॉम सागर इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ साइंस टेक्नोलॉजी एंड इंजीनियरिंग, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग, भोपाल। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न about stator design. The first slide you can see, this is your stator slots, which is in general two types of stator slots are employed in induction motors. For example, open slots and semi-closed slots. Operating performance of the induction motors depends upon the shape of the slots. Now what are open slots? In this type of slots, the slot opening will be equal to that of the width of the slots. In such type of slots, assembly and repair of windings are easy. However, such slot will lead to higher air gap contraction factor and hence poor power factor. Now what is semi-closed slots? In such type of slots, slot opening is much smaller than the width of the slot. Hence, in this type of slots, assembly of windings is more difficult and takes more time compared to open slots, and hence it is costlier. However, the air gap characteristics are better compared to open type slots. Now, what is tapered slots? In this type of slots, also opening will be much smaller than the slot width. However, the slot width will be varying from top of the slot to bottom of the slot with minimum width at the bottom. Selection of number of stator slots. The number of stator slots must be properly selected at the design stage, as such this number affects the weight, cost and operating characteristics of the motor. As there are no rules for selecting the number of stator slots, the advantages and disadvantages of selecting higher number slots help to serve as guidelines in the selection. Following are the advantages and disadvantages of selecting higher number of slots. Advantages are reduced leakage reactance, reduced tooth pulsation losses, higher overload capacity. Disadvantages are increased cost, increased weight, increased magnetizing current, increased iron losses, poor cooling, increased temperature rise, reduction in efficiency. The number of slots per pole per phase should not be less than 2, otherwise the leakage reactance becomes high. The number of slots should be selected to give an integral number of slots per pole per phase. The stator slot pitch at the air gap surface should be between 1.5 to 2.5 centimeter. Stator slot pitch at the air gap surface is equal to tau ss is equal to pi d upon sss, where sss is the number of stator slots. Turns per phase. EMF equation of an induction motor is given by EPH is equal to 4.44 F phi TPH kW. Hence, turns per phase can be obtained from EMF equation TPH is equal to EPH upon 4.44 F phi m kW. Generally, the induced EMF can be assumed to be equal to the applied voltage per phase. Flux per pole phi m is equal to BAV into pi dl upon p. Winding factor Kw may be assumed as 0.955 for full pitch distributed winding unless otherwise specified. Number conductors per phase Zph is equal to twice of Tph, and hence total number of stator conductors Z is equal to 6 times Tph, and conductors per slot Zs is equal to Z upon Ss, or 6 into Tph upon Ss. Conductor cross section. Area of cross section of stator conductors can be estimated from the stator current per phase and suitably assumed value of current density for the stator windings. Sectional area of the stator conductor AS is equal to IS upon delta S, where delta S is the current density in stator windings. Stator current per phase IS is equal to Q upon 3 VPH cos V. Cos V is your power factor, V is your theta. A suitable value of current density has to be assumed considering the advantages and disadvantages. Now, what are the advantages of higher value of current density? The first one is reduction in cross section, then reduction in weight, then reduction in cost. Disadvantages of higher value of current densities are increase in resistance, increase in copper losses, increase in temperature rise, and reduction in efficiency. Higher value is assumed for low voltage machines and small machines. Usual value of current density for stator winding is 3 to 5 amperes per mm square. Now, the area of stator slot. The slot area is occupied by the conductors and the insulation, out of which almost more than 25% is the insulations. Once the number of conductors per slot is decided, approximate area of the slot can be estimated. Slot space factor. What is this slot space factor? This is your copper area in the slot per area of each slot. This slot space factor so obtained will be between 0.25 and 0.4. Length of the mean turn. Length of the mean turn is calculated using formula LMT, which is length of mean turn is equal to 2L plus 2.3 tau plus 0.24, where L is the gross length of the stator and tau is pole pitch in meter. Depth of stator core below the slots. There will be certain solid portion below the slots in the stator, which is called the depth of the stator core. The flux density in the stator core lie between 1.2 to 1.4 Tesla. The flux passing through the stator core is half of the flux per pole. Flux in the stator core section phi c is equal to half of phi. Area of stator core AC is equal to phi c upon 2 BC. Area of stator core AC is equal to Li XDCS. Hence, depth of the core DCS is equal to AC upon Li is equal to phi c upon twice BC into Li. Using the design data obtained so far, outer diameter of the stator core can be calculated as D0 is equal to D plus twice of depth of stator slots plus depth of core is equal to d plus 2 dss plus 2 dcs. Rotor design. There are two types of rotor construction. One is the squirrel cage rotor and the other is the slip ring rotor. Most of the induction motor are squirrel cage type. These are having the advantage of rugged and simple in construction and comparatively cheaper. However, they have the disadvantage of lower starting torque. In this type, the rotor consists of bars of copper or aluminium accommodated in rotor slots. In case slip ring induction motors, the rotor complex in construction and costlier, with the advantage that they have the better starting torque. This type of rotor consists of star connected distributed three phase windings. Length of air gap between stator and rotor is the air gap, which is a very critical part. The performance parameters of the motor like magnetizing current, power factor, overload capacity, cooling and noise are affected by length of this air gap. Power factor. The MMF required to send the flux through air gap is proportional to the product of flux density and length of the air gap. The figure here shows phasor diagram of an induction motor with two different air gap lengths. With increase in air gap length, magnetizing MMF increases and hence greater the magnetizing current. Therefore, the phase angle between applied voltage and stator current will increase, which gives low power factor. Overload capacity of induction motor is the ratio of maximum output of rated output and the maximum output is obtained from circuit diagram. The diameter of circuit diagram is Vs upon Xs, where Xs is reactance of motor. The length of air gap affects the leakage reactance. If the length of air gap is large, the leakage flux is reduced, hence reduced value of leakage reactance. With decrease in the value of leakage reactance, the diameter of circle diagram increases and hence the overload capacity increases. Pulsation loss. The tooth pulsation losses, which is produced due to variation in reactance of the air gap, is reduced with large air gap. Now cooling. The large air gap provide better facilities for cooling at the gap surfaces due to the cylindrical surfaces of stator and rotor are separated by large distance. Noise in induction motor reduced with increase in air gap length due to reduction in leakage flux, which is the cause of noise. Hence, length of the air gap is selected considering the advantages and disadvantages of larger air gap length. Let us see advantages. Increased overload capacity, increased cooling, reduced unbalanced magnetic pull, reduced in tooth pulsation, reduced noise. Disadvantages are increased magnetizing current, reduced power factor. Magnetizing current and power factor being very important parameters in deciding the performance of induction motors. The induction motors are designed for optimum value of air gap or minimum air gap possible. Hence, in designing the length of the air gap, following empirical formula is employed. Air gap length LG is equal to 0.2 plus 2 under root DLMM. Now the design of squirrel cage rotor. Let us see number of slots. Proper number of rotor slots are to be selected in relation to number of stator slots, otherwise undesirable effects will be found at the starting of the motor. Cogging and crawling are the two phenomena which are observed due to wrong combination of number of rotor and stator slots. In addition, induction motor may develop unpredictable hooks and cusps in torque speed characteristics, or the motor may run with lot of noise. Crawling. The rotating magnetic field produced in the air gap will be usually non-sinusoidal and generally contains odd harmonics of the order 3rd, 5th and 7th. The third harmonic flux will produce the three times the magnetic poles compared to that of the fundamental. Similarly, the fifth and seventh harmonic will produce the poles 5 and 7 times the fundamental respectively. The presence of harmonics in the flux wave affects the torque speed characteristic. The motor with presence of 7th harmonics is to have a tendency to run the motor at 1/7 of its normal speed. Now what is cogging? In some cases where in the number of rotor slots are not proper in relation to number of stator slots, the machine refuses to run and remains stationary. Under such conditions, there will be a locking tendency between the rotor and stator. Such a phenomena is called cogging. Hence, in order to avoid such bad effects, a proper number of rotor slots are to be selected in relation to number of stator slots. In addition, rotor slots will be skewed by one slot pitch to minimize the tendency of cogging. Torque defects like synchronous hooks and cusps and noisy operations while running. Effect of squibbing will slightly increase the rotor resistance and increases the starting torque. However, this will increase the leakage reactance and hence reduces the starting current and power factor. Selection of number of rotor slots. The number of rotor slots may be selected using the following guidelines. First one is to avoid cogging and crawling. A. SS must not be equal to SR. B. SS minus SR must not be equal to 3P. Second, to avoid synchronous hooks and cusps in torque speed characteristic, SS minus SR must not be equal to P, 2P and 5P. Third one is to noisy operation, SS minus SR must not be equal to 1, 2, P plus minus 1 or P plus minus 2. Rotor bar current. Bar current in the rotor of a squirrel cage induction motor may be determined by comparing the MMF developed in rotor and stator. The stator MMF is about 15% higher because of magnetizing MMF. Rotor MMF is equal to 0.85. Stator MMF. Number of rotor bars is equal to NB is equal to SR is equal to number of rotor slots. Rotor bar current is equal to IB. Rotor MMF is equal to IB into SR upon 2. Stator MMF is equal to 3 into IS into TS. Thus, IB into SR upon 2 is equal to 0.85 into 3 into IS into TS, or IB is equal to 0.85 into 6 IS TS upon SR. Cross sectional area of rotor bar. Sectional area of rotor conductor can be calculated by rotor bar current and assumed value of current density for rotor bars. As a guideline, the rotor bar current density can be assumed between 4 to 7 ampere per mm square. Hence, sectional area of the rotor bars can be calculated as AB is equal to IB upon delta B mm square. Shape and size of the rotor slots. Generally, semi-closed slots or closed slots with very small or narrow openings are employed for the rotor slots. In case of fully closed slots, the rotor bars are force fit into the slot from the sides of the rotor. The rotors with closed slots are giving performance to the motor in the following way. First, as the rotor slot is closed, the rotor surface is smooth at the air gap and hence the motor draws lower magnetizing current. Second, reduced noise as the air gap characteristics are better. Third, increased leakage reactance and fourth, reduced starting current. Overload capacity is reduced. Undesirable and complex air gap characteristics from the above, it can be concluded that semi-closed slots are more suitable and hence are employed in rotors. Copper loss in rotor bars. Knowing the length of rotor bars and resistance of the rotor bars, copper losses in the rotor bars can be calculated. Length of rotor bar LB is equal to L plus allowance for skewing. Rotor bar resistance is equal to 0.21 into LB upon AB. Copper loss in rotor bars is equal to IB square into RB into number of rotor bars. Now, end ring current. All the rotor bars are short circuited by connecting them to the end rings at both the end rings. As the rotor is a short circuited, there will be current flow because of induced EMF in the rotor bars. The distribution of current and end rings are as shown in figure. Considering the bars under one pole pitch, half of the number of bars and the end ring carry the current in one direction and the other half in the opposite direction. Thus, the maximum end ring current may be taken as the sum of the average current in half of the number of bars under one pole. See this diagram. Maximum end ring current, that is IE max, is equal to number of bars over half a pole pitch, IBAV, SR upon 2P into 2 by pi into IB max, SR into IB max upon pi into P. RMS value of bar current IB is equal to IB max upon root 2. IE max is equal to SR into IB into root 2 upon pi into P. RMS value of end ring current IE is equal to IE max upon root 2. IE is equal to SR into IB upon pi into P. Area of end ring. Knowing the end ring current and assuming suitable value for the current density in the end ring's cross section for the end ring can be calculated. Current density in the end ring may be assumed as 4.5 to 7.5 ampere per mm square. Area of each end ring AE is equal to IE upon delta E mm square. AE is equal to TE into DE, where TE is equal to thickness of end ring and DE is equal to depth of end ring. Now, what is design of wound rotor? There are the types of induction motor where in rotor also carries distributed star connected three phase winding. At one end of the rotor, there are three slip rings mounted on the shaft. Three ends of the winding are connected to the slip rings. External resistances can be connected to these slip rings at starting, which will be inserted in series with the windings, which will help in increasing the torque at starting. Such type of induction motors are employed where high starting torque is required. Number of rotor slots. The number of rotor slots should never be equal to number of stator slots. Generally, for wound rotor motors, a suitable value is assumed for number of rotor slots per pole per phase, and then total number of rotor slots are calculated. So, selected number of slots should be such that tooth width must satisfy the flux density limitation. Semi-closed slots are used for rotor slots. Number of rotor turns. The voltage between the slip rings on open circuit must be limited to safety values. In general, the voltage between the slip rings for low and medium voltage machines must be limited to 400 volts. For motors with higher voltage ratings and large size motors, this voltage must be limited to 1000 volts. Based on the assumed voltage between the slip rings, comparing the induced voltage ratio in stator and rotor, the number of turns on rotor winding can be calculated. Voltage ratio ER upon ES is equal to KWR into TR upon KWS into TS. Hence, rotor turns per phase TR is equal to ER upon ES, KWS upon KWR into TS, where ER is equal to open circuit rotor voltage per phase, ES is equal to stator voltage per phase, KWS is equal to winding factor for stator, KWR is equal to winding factor for rotor, TS is equal to number of stator turns per phase. Rotor current and conductor section. Assuming rotor MMF is equal to 0.85 stator MMF, 2 into 3 into IR into TR is equal to 0.85 2 into 3 into IS into TS. Rotor current per phase IR is equal to 0.85 IS into TS upon T. Rotor conductor area AR is equal to IR upon delta R. The current density could be taken as 3 to 5 ampere per mm square. Now, no load current. The no load current of an induction motor has two components, magnetizing component IM and iron loss component IW. Thus, the no load current I0 is equal to under root IM square plus IW square ampere. Magnetizing current of an induction motor is responsible for producing the required amount of flux in the different parts of the machine. Hence, this current can be calculated from all the magnetic circuit of the machine. The ampere turns for all the magnetic circuits such as stator core, stator teeth, air gap, rotor core and rotor teeth gives the total ampere turns required for the magnetic circuit. Based on the total ampere turns of the magnetic circuit, the magnetizing current can be calculated as magnetizing current IM is equal to P into AT60 upon 2.34 kW TPH, where P number of pair of poles, AT30 is your total number, total ampere turns of the magnetic circuit at 60 degree from the center of the pole, TPH is equal to number of stator turns per phase. Iron loss component of current. This component of current is responsible for supplying the iron loss in the magnetic circuit. Hence, this component can be calculated from no load losses and applied voltage. Iron loss component of current IW is equal to total no load losses upon 3 into phase voltage. No load power factor of an induction motor is very poor. As the load on the machine increases, the power factor improves. No load power factor can be calculated knowing the components of no load current. No load power factor cos V0 is equal to IW upon I0. Dispersion coefficient. Power factor is an important factor in designing of induction motor, power factor depends upon two factors. Magnetizing current. A large value of magnetizing current indicates poor power factor. Ideal short circuit current, ISC. It is defined as the current drawn by the motor at standstill, neglecting its resistance. A large value of ideal short circuit current will be drawn for a small value of leakage reactance, giving good power factor. Dispersion coefficient, defined as the ratio of magnetizing current to ideal short circuit current. Thus, dispersion coefficient sigma is equal to Im upon ISCI is equal to Im upon ES upon XS is equal to Im into XS upon ES, where ISCI is equal to ES upon XS. For small values of Im and XS, dispersion coefficient is small and power factor is good. Thus, for a small value of dispersion coefficient, power factor is good. Whereas, for large value of dispersion coefficient, power factor is poor. Magnetizing current Im is equal to P into 8060 upon 2.34 kW TPH, where 8060 is the total MMF consumed by flux path, out of which a large part is consumed by air gap length. 80 air gap is equal to 800000 into 1.36 into BAV LG. ISCI is equal to ES upon XS. You can calculate all these things. Thus, dispersion coefficient sigma is equal to Im upon ISC alpha into PLG lambda upon DK square WS QS. From equation, machine a given LED, the dispersion coefficient is large for greater number of poles, consequently making power factor poor. Thus, slow speed machine have poor power factor. Effect of dispersion coefficient on induction motor characteristic. Effect on maximum power factor. As shown in circle diagram, OA is equal to magnetizing current, OB is equal to ideal short circuit current. Dispersion coefficient sigma is equal to AA upon OB. Maximum power factor is equal to cos phi minimum is equal to DC upon OC is equal to AB by 2 upon OB minus AB by 2 is equal to AB upon twice OB minus AB. For maximum power factor, OD is tangent to the circle and angle ODC is equal to 90 degree. OB minus OA upon OB plus OA is equal to 1 minus OA upon OB divided by 1 plus OA upon OB is equal to 1 minus sigma upon 1 plus sigma. For sigma is equal to 0.05, maximum power factor is equal to 0.905. For sigma is equal to 0.10, maximum power factor is equal to 0.818. Hence, there is a large decrease in maximum power factor when the dispersion coefficient increases. Now, the effect on overload capacity. Assuming an induction motor is designed to have maximum power factor at full load, its corresponding output will be DE. The maximum output will be corresponding to FC. Overload capacity is equal to maximum power output upon full load output is equal to FC upon DE is equal to AC upon DC sin phi minimum is equal to 1 upon sin phi minimum is equal to 1 upon root under 1 minus cos phi minimum whole square is equal to 1 upon root under 1 minus sigma upon 1 plus sigma whole square is equal to 1 plus sigma upon 2 root under sigma. For sigma is equal to 0.05, overload capacity is equal to 2.348. for sigma is equal to 0.10, overload capacity is equal to 1.740. Hence, overload capacity decreases with increase in dispersion coefficient. This is all about in this video. We'll be back with another video with the remaining topics. Till then, thank you so much.